And we are back. Analog Girl is a health and wellness podcast with topics curated for anxiety management, mental health awareness, self-help, and personal growth. Now, joining us and sharing more about the details is the founder and creator of the Analog Girl podcast, LaToya D. Newton. And we welcome you now, and good to have you.
Thank you.
So you created this Analog Girl podcast with a special intention in mind, and that was to deal with what?
Anxiety,
right.
Because that was what I was struggling with for quite some time, and I hadn't pinpointed what it was. And then I was able to pinpoint it about last year, 2018, and that's when I decided to tell my story and then to help other people too.
And so when you talk about anxiety, obviously it was something that you battled with for a long period of time. Talk a little bit about your story and what got you there.
So my anxiety came from a lot of childhood trauma. It manifested itself in me as something called depersonalization. And that was last year. So it was kind of like a disconnect for me. I disassociated and I felt like I was in this dream world and I just didn't feel real. I couldn't function and it affected me in a way where I lost my job. It was just a whole downward spiral. So that's how it affected me. But it affects other people in very different kind of ways, like panic attacks, or it could be OCD, or it could be PTSD. So that's exactly what I was going through and why I wanted to share that story.
So now you got this podcast going, and you share this, and you talk about anxiety, and you deal with that, and you're very real about it. So give us a little bit about the podcast and what people get when they tune in.
So I am very real because I'm a Bronx girl, I just wanted to be relatable to everybody because anxiety does affect a lot of us. I think it's about 40 million people in the U.S. alone are affected by anxiety, and then women who are twice as likely to get it. So I thought that I should create something for women, especially women of color, to talk and be able to be relatable to them so that they are not ashamed or afraid to speak up about what they're going through and the stresses and the depression that comes with anxiety.
And sometimes we hide that, right? We hide the anxiety, the stress, and the PTSD. Sometimes we go around undiagnosed, right? And we have these things. Do you feel like you're able to get a message across to people about it's okay and we can talk about this and you can get some help?
Absolutely, because I also make light of it, because a lot of things that I've gone through, like, you know, freaking out on a train or something, sometimes there's humor in that and me going a little crazy sometimes about being nervous about coming on this show, actually, you know. So I think that it's very relatable and people are open to sharing their stories when they hear other people sharing their stories too as well. And also seeking treatment, because a lot of us, a third of us out of that group of 4 million people, don't seek treatment.
And when we talk about minorities, right, and particularly in communities of color, it's a stigma not to seek treatment for mental health. But I've often said, you know, if your arm is messed up, you go see the doctor.
Yep.
If my foot is messed up, I'm going to see the doctor. And now, if something's going wrong with me mentally, then it's okay to get checked out.
Well, and that's very true. And I think what happens when you bring up that example of if your foot is broken, it's something that you can see. It's something tangible. But with anxiety, you can't see it. So some people are out and about, and they're looking great, but they don't understand why they're feeling a hot mess on the inside.
Yeah. So listen, you just had a picnic recently.
Yes.
And so it was called Unplug and Recharge Your Black Girl Magic. What happened?
So I brought together a lot of women. We came together, some people who do suffer with anxiety or PTSD or any other kind of mental illness, or women who just don't, and they just wanted to unplug and recharge. We set goals for ourselves. We evaluated the goals that we did set from the beginning of the year. And if we missed those marks, then we created a vision board, and we just talked about how we're going to finish up the year strong.
And we're watching some video from the actual picnic right there.
Yeah,
and, and so the day itself, you know, when you go back and look at the day, what are your thoughts?
I was just so happy that we were able to connect with so many women. I was surprised that the event actually sold out and that they were so willing to participate in this. And they were open to the meditation, they were open to the prayer, they were open to everything. And I was just very excited about it.
And it's a conversation sometimes people don't necessarily want to have, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so you're really like cracking this nut here. Talk to me about that. Do you feel like more and more people are really cracking the nut to say, listen, I want to talk about this, I want to deal with this, given the fact we just talked about suicide a little while ago, and sometimes these are things that actually lead to, like, suicide, right? So
absolutely.
Are we progressing?
I think we're progressing, and I think that's the reason why I want to keep talking about it, just to take the shame away from it, because I think we do deal a lot with shame and embarrassment because you don't want people to think that you're crazy or that you're not capable of being a normal person. And we all are normal, and we all deal with anxiety. It's just how we learn how to cope with it.
The big difference there. Mm-hmm. So for people who want to get connected to the podcast,
okay, so you can find the podcast on most platforms. It's iTunes, Google Play, Spotify, Stitcher. You just search Analog Girl Podcast, and I'm there. And be sure to subscribe and rate. And then also you can find it on theanaloggirl.com. I also post all the episode notes every week for that. And the new episode for season 2 is coming out next week on Wednesday.
So you ready for it?
I am ready.
What are the topics you really want to deal with in season 2?
I think I want to focus more on the coping and the recovery. So last season I talked about my struggle a lot, and I was always ranting and just going on about what my daily struggle was for week in, week out. Mm-hmm. And this season I would like to just talk more about how we can recover and how we can move forward to be able to cope with these things throughout our day-to-day.
So you gave the example, like you were getting ready to come on the show, felt a little anxiety about coming
on
the show. Feel better now?
I feel better.
Okay, cool. Yeah. So but how did you cope? How'd you deal?
So it's not really about positive thinking. It's more about positive talking and positive dialogue that I tell myself. So it's just like, I'm having a good time. This is great. Relax, girl. This is just, it's simple. It's only 7 minutes. It's, you know, it's a more of a talking and a dialogue with myself to keep myself calm.
So you can come back and do it again?
Yeah, I could.
You'll be cool with it?
I'll be cool.
All right, that's what I want to know. All right, then Latoya D is the founder and creator of the Analog Girl Podcast. And once again, it's on all platforms, right?
All platforms.
Right. So we want to let you know, you can check out an all new episode of the Analog Girl Podcast every Wednesday. Just like open right here every Wednesday, right? Yep. And for more information on Latoya D and the Analog Girl Podcast, you can visit her website at theanaloggirl.com or on Facebook at Analog Girl Podcast. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with more show coming up right after this. About to get your dance on coming up in a minute.